Hey, what's up? It's Chris, founder of Thinkster.com, and in today's video, from my living room, I want to welcome our new Thinkster freelancer student, Justin, to the freelancer course. So welcome, Justin, to the freelancer course. Great to have you on board. I'm really excited for you because I know that this will probably be a very good decision to start your freelancing career, to start becoming self-employed. It sure has been for me when I started my freelancing career a couple of years ago, and then it's like my freelancing business morphed into a more scalable business and cost-like business, but still, I mean, it has been the pivotal point in my career to actually start my own business. So I'm really excited about the opportunities these days for freelancers. So in this welcome videos, I want to first of all tell you welcome and appreciate you joining the course, but I also want to give you some practical tips and advice on the way that you can use. For example, like one category of those freelancing advices are some niches where you can position yourself in, because as you go through the course, you'll realize that that I'm a big proponent of finding your specific niche, your specific value delivery proposition that you can offer to clients, so that you can like fill, like be the best in your niche. Because no matter how large the niche is, if you belong to the top, say 5 or 10% of the coders in this niche, you probably earn like $100 or more per hour. So it's like very likely that you can demand this premium rates if you are one of the best people in your niche. And of course, that's why you probably, if you are not the expert already, a world-class expert in a certain niche or subfield, so therefore you need to pick a very small, very, very specific niche where you can really excel and be the people in the world. So what are some examples of niches? You can go through previous videos, actually, from previous welcome videos where I propose some other niches, but I think one exciting niche I found out, like I already knew that it exists, but I didn't know that actually you could make some money out of it, which is the solving the labeling problem for machine learning centric companies. So what does it mean? Actually, if you like, machine learning is one big trend and it won't get away, so it will only become stronger and stronger in the upcoming decades. This is kind of obvious to everyone in the space, right? But like, not so obvious is that for machine learning to work, you need training data, of course. So, and the training data must be high quality. So you need often supervised or labeled training data, which means that you have some data inputs, and you need to have the label of this training data. So the input-output relationship, you need to have the output for a certain input, right? So for example, in face detection, you need to have many faces, and then also not only the faces, but you also need, for example, the sex or the expected age or so of the face associated to it. And oftentimes humans are the best labeling. So humans, like, they label millions of data items. They just get presented faces, for example, and they just label it. Like, they get a face, they label it with a woman, or get a face, label it with man, get a face, label it with age 32 or so. Yeah. So and this is often done by humans, and this can actually be a great first step without needing any skills. I mean, you already, like, what does it mean without you needing any skills? You already have a lot of skills as a human. For example, for you, this labeling problem is simple. But for machines, it's actually crucial, and machines cannot do it by themselves. Therefore, I mean, you need to feed the machine this labeled training data. So this is one industry that will become very relevant in the upcoming decades. I listened to the earnings call of the Tesla earnings release, and Elon Musk actually said this, that they like, this labeling problem is at the core of their autonomic driving problem. So they need to have large amounts of data. They already have large amounts of camera data, but they also need it labeled. So they use machines to label the data, but it doesn't work perfect. And many companies, actually, what they do, they just hire people, freelancers, amounts of training data, so that they can then feed their machine learning models into it. And I think it's still a very so you could still own this niche, yeah. So you can be like, focus on a certain sub niche, maybe in the labeling space, and then just label training data initially to get your foot in the door in the machine learning. You offer your services, labeling, for example, 1,000 training data for $100 or so, and then you just keep labeling data, and over time you can use it as to get a foot in the door with clients. You can also propose some models on top of this. So if you already have the training data, you can start training your own models on top of this training data and submit this to the clients to really delight the clients and to really to maybe get a long-term relationship with those clients who actually need the machine learning expertise. So I think this whole labeling space, there are so many opportunities, I cannot even list all of them, but I think just being a labeler, this is one job type that will become more and more important in the future. And I think you can just get your freelancing career started doing this, and then build upon this and build upon your relationship with clients to get more and more advanced type of gigs in the machine learning space. Okay, so thanks for joining the course. Great to have you on board, and I wish you well. And if you need anything, just contact me via the commenting function in the freelancer course, or just write in the Python Mastermind group. I check in like every 2-3 days to see if there have been any new comments submitted. But usually, if you submit a post in the Pfingster Freelancer Mastermind group, then people will respond to your post and will help you out, because the community of the Pfingster Freelancer course is really it's a great community. I'm really proud of the people there who help each other out and to create real synergies for each other to ensure their mutual success. Okay, so thanks for joining again, and see you in the course. Bye.